We are currently looking at the 5 cycle lands from Amonkhet. We have Sheltered Thicket, Irrigated Farmlands, Shattered Grove, Fetid Pools, and Canyon Sludge. And this video is actually a review on these cards that I actually think are quite good. Now, just like everyone else, at first glance, I consider these lands quite bad due to the fact that they come into play tapped. And I believe that's the big reason that they are quite overlooked. The reason I actually started playing those lands was because I was experimenting with these two cards, Bubbling Muck and High Tide. I was playing a Storm deck and I wanted to find more rituals. So High Tide is a pretty darn good ritual. You tap it for 1 blue mana, and now every island you tap for mana will produce more mana. So I played a multicolor deck that had a lot of different colors in it, so I couldn't play only basic islands. So what I did was that I started looking at every single land in the Magic the Gathering universe that was an island and something else, like Fetid Pools, that was both an island and a swamp, meaning it would function pretty good with both Bubbling Muck and High Tide. And then I also started to add in Canergy Sludge. I did not play Irrigated Farmlands in that deck because I did not have the color identity of white. In the end, I realized that I actually liked the lands. They didn't mess up the deck that much, and they provided that possibility of cycling them away whenever I drew nothing but lands, to be able to dig through the deck and find my win cons, or interaction. Because in the end, you don't really need too much mana, because sometimes you're going to flood with mana, drawing nothing but lands. And then suddenly you have too much mana, and you don't really need more mana, and you'd rather have something that will do something, and you just want to dig through your deck. And then paying 2 mana, cycle one of these lands, is actually quite good. And the second reason why I do like Amonkhet cycling land cards is because you can actually fetch them with your fetch lands. Because let's say that it's turn 2 and you have a basic island in play, and then you put a Flooded Strands in play, and then you pass turn. Because what you can do now is be ready with your counterspell. If someone is doing something horrible that you don't want to happen, you can sacrifice your Flooded Strand to put Watery Grave into play and pay 2 life to have it untapped. And then just tap these 2 lands and use the counterspell to disrupt your opponent. But if nothing really interesting is happening, you can basically just sacrifice Flooded Strand before your turn starts, and then put Fetid Pools into play tapped, and then go to your untap step, untap this land, and you're fine. Perfect. We can basically fetch the land that comes into play tapped once we don't really care that it comes into play tapped. And whenever we want a land to enter the battlefield untapped, we basically go for the normal shock land. Also, these lands are pretty cheap at a really low money cost. You could get them at a really low price. And they are still quite good. I actually play 1 to 2 of these Amonkhet cycling lands in my budget-less decks, meaning decks that run dual lands. So even though they are really low cost, I think they are quite good enough to be played. At least that's my opinion. I actually value the option of cycling away lands. In the end, however, I don't recommend playing all of them if you're running 5 colored decks. If you're running a 3 colored deck, like let's say you're running Tassigur, I would still play this, and that would pretty much be enough. If you're playing a 4 colored deck, like Thrasios and Tymna, then maybe, a big maybe, I might play these 2, not this one. Because you'd rather have untapped forest that comes into play. You want to be able to cast your Birds of Paradise the first turn. However, when game goes a little bit longer, you want the more colors that are you want more of, like blue, so you have more options as counterspells. In any case, I do believe in these lands, and I do recommend them. And thank you so much for watching.